Hey y'all, just wanted to pop in real quick and talk about CNN's town hall last night with Kamala Harris. I live tweeted the town hall on Twitter at BWNAV, so go check that out. And I think you're going to see a lot of highlights from her performance last night. She did a stellar job. Let's keep in mind, it is 1 week into her presidential campaign and she has been firing all cylinders. She had a huge 20,000 person rally in her hometown of Oakland. She was born in America. Don't do that birther stuff with her. And then she had a completely solid performance last night on the town hall. What people have to realize is that we're a full year away from the first Iowa caucus and the Democratic primaries. And so right now it's not all about getting super specific and wonky and into policies. It's about establishing a theme for your campaign, fleshing out your biography, letting people know what you're about, who you are, and why you would be a viable candidate. And under those conditions, I think she hit it out the park last night. So unsurprisingly, one of the first questions that was brought up was about race. And she had other questions about race and gender and things like that. And she does a good job when it comes to her immigrant parents' background. But when it comes to questions of her racial identity, she sucks. Okay, she needs to do some work on it. And I love Kamala. I'm team Kamala. But her answers are not good. She comes across like she's uncomfortable with the question. Like she hasn't quite figured out how to thread that needle. I get it. She doesn't want to come out. Oh, Angela Davis, I'm black and I'm proud. Shout out to Angela Davis. Being a black woman is going to make it harder for her to win the nomination. People aren't convinced yet that a black woman can win. So I get that part. But you also have to realize that black people are very sensitive. Okay, and they don't like people that don't look like they're trying to claim being black, all right? That's the problem. And they already on her ass about everything, about her edges, her ponytail, Cardi B, her husband, her prosecutorial background. So when it comes to these racial questions, she has to get better at figuring out how she wants to present herself. So the last thing I'll say is she gave some barn burner answers. My favorite one was her answer on gun control. It was one of the best answers I've heard from a politician in a very long time. I can't do it any justice by repeating it, so I won't. She talked about the Green Deal. She talked about her tax cut. She proposed already in Congress the LIFT Act. It was one of 52, I think, bills that she sponsored, 396 that she co-sponsored. She has a record, y'all. Try reading it sometime instead of just talking about her being a prosecutor. It gives families $500 a month tax credit. I know I can use that because I'm getting killed in these Trump taxes. Listen, she's not going to out Bernie. She's not going to out Warren, Elizabeth Warren. She's not going to go full AOC on us, okay? But what she is going to do, and I think what she successfully did, was she presented herself as a very sensible, intelligent, smart, capable candidate. She's very authentic. And she's a force to be reckoned with. And so she is going to be very tough to beat in the primary, and she can 100% totally beat Trump.